What is going on, everyone? Hadex Gaming here, and today I'm bringing you the first episode of a new playthrough. It will be a summon only on brutal mode. So as you can see, I've got my mage only brutal mode save here. If you want to check that out, I've got the full 18 hours worth over on my VODs channel. There's a playlist for that. So jump on over there, check it out. I'll have the link in the description below. But let's hop into a new world. Player name is Hadex the Summoner. And I'm going to go brutal mode. Summon only. There we go. Continue. Difficulty. Brutal. Drop materials. Enable player hunger. All that good stuff. Raid frequency is going to be often. As high as I can get it. And then random seed. All that good stuff. And let's jump in. Alrighty then. Let's start by getting off some wood. Now, I need to get rid of this sword because I'm not allowed to use that. I am, however, allowed to use melee tools. So like pickaxes, axe, shovels, primarily for gathering materials. But if I accidentally hit an enemy, that's not a big deal. There's not much I can really do about that. So let's do that. And then I kind of need, I know where to get the first few summon items, being like the magic branch from the ice biome or the brain on a stick. But the brain on the stick's kind of rare because it's from the traveling merchant. So let me just get some of this. And then I think, I'm not sure where I want to build my settlement yet, but let's grab everything I need from it. And then that way I've got something. So let's go over here to the chest, grab some stuff. What stuff has he got for me? Settlement flag, a village map, a dungeon map, and some bread, which will come in handy. I thought about stealing his bed then, but I was like, nah, I might better leaving it. So let's quickly explore this island for any surface level chests. And then I need to jump over to a snow biome, start really looking for a weapon. So this part could be part of the grind, but I imagine the troubles I'm going to see in this series is finding equipment or getting equipment. I think I see something on the map here. Yeah, wait, here we go. So, finding equipment's going to be difficult. Keen enchanting scroll, that's great. And a fuzzy dice, that's epic. A combat regen and a first boss portal, which is amazing. So, if I press N, I can go to that snow or that snow. I'm going to go left. I know some of the armor requires wool, but I don't really want to kill the sheep with a tool. I want to get a summon weapon first. So let's set off to the snow biome. Okay, snow biome, here we go. And man, I hope I get real lucky getting a weapon. So today's episode, I kind of want to get a weapon, maybe some spider armor, and then I also got to check out a pirate village. Now, the pirate village is important because it has, I think, two trinkets from memory. It's got the summon trinket and a lifeline trinket. So for brutal mode, that lifeline trinket essentially allows me to get another extra hit off. Most things will kill me in one or two hits. So having a lifeline means if I was to die, I get 25% of my health back, and then I can at least take another hit. So, surface chests. I don't know if they can drop in surface chests, but I want to find out if there's one anyway, because I could always take another trinket or another enchanting scroll. Plus, I don't know if the boss portal will give me the summoning foci that I need. So let's run around and check. I'm not going to touch the polar bear. Not yet. Maybe I can test out a summon on it later. And then I also need a ton of food. So I'm going to go around and grab all of these because they will come in handy later when I need food. And there we go. There is a surface chest. I was so close to it when I came in. All right, what's in here? Flippers, perfect, and 10 extra health. Nice, another one of these potions. Wait, no, no, no. I wanted to pop them up there. There we go. Sort that out. There we go. And I might actually take the chest too. Why not? So with that out of the way, let's make a ladder. See if I can find some stuff. I want to make some torches. All right, there's a chest here. Not the one I'm after, though. And I'll take that, too, so I don't have to craft my own. Oh, I can't. Oh, man. All right, let me get back up. I'm going to make a crafting table real quick. And a pickaxe. I need logs. I thought I chopped down a ton of logs. All right, guess not. All right, that should be enough. Pickaxe. There we go. Okay. Got a pickaxe. I should be able to mine that up now. Yeah, perfect. And then good to know that I can come back here when I need to defeat the spider. This is actually very risky. Something could sneak up on me and just insta-kill me. Yep. So let's dig this up. And let's... I'm going to have to just trial and error until I find something. Nothing really... Oh, hang on. Yes, there's something here. Oh, is that two things connected or is that a vampire nest? Please be two and not a vampire nest. It's a vampire nest. Hey, please. Yes. All right, we got our first weapon and another... damage scroll. So let's actually pop the damage on that. Summon. I can only have one at a time at the moment. And then I'm gonna have to be sneaky about how I kill things. So let's see. I need to be killing the spiders. Now that I've got a weapon, because the spiders will get me spider armor. And I believe spider armor is just cave gland. But this will be very difficult because one hit from them will probably kill me. Yeah, I gotta bail. All right, hopefully they disappear. Kill the sheep, please. I need wool. Thank you. I go back down. Is he still there? Oh, he's still there. All right, just kill the sheep. Might just have to wait a little while for him to disappear again and despawn. All right, let's head back. Is he still there? He's still there, but I think... Yes. Black cave spider. Go on. Bite him. Bite him. Snowman. Stop being chicken and just bite him. I have to watch out for the acid that he spits. Yes. Nice. Now I just need a couple more of them. Oh, is that another treasure chest? It is a chest, but not the one I need. Wait, is there even a chest there? I can't tell. I saw more spiders. Oh god, is that two of them? Did you just pick a fight with two spiders? Three spiders. He picked a fight with three spiders. Just focus on one place. Oh boy, that was close. Ah! Oh, I'm left on 12 HP. Right, please kill him. This is great. This is great. Please just stay there while he dies. Please and thank you. That zombie is terrifying. Right, please kill him fast enough before he gets to me. Ah, no. Alright, this is going to be a problem because I need the item. And I've got no potion. And I don't want to go down and then just die in one hit. Ooh, that was so close. Ooh, that was terrifying. Okay. Now, can I make that armor on this? Yes, I can get one max summon with that. That's huge. That will help dramatically. Now I've got twice the damage. All right, that's speeding things up massively. So, how many did I need? That's Widow stuff. That's way later. But good to know that I need Cave Spider Glands for that. Helmet was 7. Chest is 10. And the boots are 4. Okay. So let's make the boots. This is going really well. So after I get the full armor set, I gotta go check out a pirate island. I don't really have anything to smash things open with, which is a worry. Because that's where all the good loot comes from, like all my potions and stuff. Yes! Alright, we can get the full set. And I think the full set bonus gives me an extra summon as well. So let's jump out. Make the chest piece. And set bonus, 1 max summons. And my attacks poison the target for 10 damage over 5 seconds. I wonder if that's my summons as well that do that. I want to test that out, actually. There could be some good loot in here. Yeah, there might actually be some good loot, so I might actually have to clear that out. Can I summon them in there? Is that possible? Nope, I gotta break this. Whoa, okay. I didn't see if that poisoned him though. Oh god, they bounce. I wasn't paying attention. Apprentice blood bolt, sharp, is for a tool. Okay. The only tool I'll be using is the pickaxe and the axe, so it's not really a big deal. And aside from those, I'm the next biggest tool. Alright, mine these up. They contain potions and gold bars and things like that. So I think that might just be the best summon armor I get for a while. I can't remember what the next upgrade for armor will be. Did I check that one? I did not. I definitely got that one, right? Yes. I might grab that just for my my villagers. I can, like, gear them up. So I think that's everything I want from down here. Let's check out the pirate village for some summons. Where are you guys going? That's weird. Don't know where they were heading off to. Should I put my... test my luck and see how good 3 summons go against the polar bear. Come on, guys. Can you get him? Yes, thank you. Oh, I regret. No, get me in the water. Get me in the water. Oh boy. Okay, so they're doing 1 damages. What's my next best summon weapon? That is crazy. I don't know how I'm gonna defeat things if they're not doing damage. So is there a pirate island anywhere? There's a void dungeon. I could go there, see what I get. Or I head to the village now that I've got full set of armor. I'm gonna go to the village, see if I can tackle the first boss. Maybe. Let's tackle that first boss. Okay, so I need them to kill the sheep too. Because I need wool. Oh, look at this chest. It's like a surface chest that got ruined by a path. Oh, boss portal. Savage. Yes. That's huge. Get rid of the ice wall. Because what? Nothing. All right. You get Savage Enchanting Scroll. You've now got 15% damage and 10% summon speed. That is massive. Yes. There we go. Oh, they've got more sheep. So how much wool do I have? 17. I don't know how much I need, but I want it. Thank you. Okay, next up. I sleep in a bed. And I go from there. Because if I go in here, any equipment, right? Nothing here that helps me. None of that summon stuff. None of it's any good for me. So there's no point. The only thing that I'd really want later on are some minion potions. So let's wait till nighttime. I'm gonna see if I can defeat the first boss. I don't think I've got too many potions, so it could be a bit of a struggle. I'm hoping the villagers will let me win. All right, nighttime. Let's... Is that a guard? That was a guard. Let's light up the place. How many potions have I... I've only got 3 potions, so that's, that could be bad. There's also mummies, which are terrifying. Thank you. All right. Wow, that did a lot of damage. 50% HP in phase 1. That is insane. Also, this new soundtrack is so good. Yeah, I didn't think he'd be down long. I nearly skipped an entire phase last time. Alright, all the guards are here, so let's hope that they all help me. Yes! And then what did I get? Demonic Heart, Demonic Bar, Force of Range. Bugger. That's not what I wanted. Cabbage seeds, raw mutton I need. What don't I need? That, I guess, or that. All right, let's go again. It's unfortunate. Ouch, that deals a lot of damage to me. I gotta get back up into the middle here. So the boss will always look to find someone within like a 10 tile radius to land on me. See? Please kill him. Please, please. Thank you. Where are the guards at? I need them. Oh, these homing bullets are risky. I think I avoided the homing bullets. So it's coming back. I avoided them. Alright. Summons are actually crazy strong. I guess I've got 3 villagers killing him too. Did I get it? Melee foci. Damn, I need the other ones. So let's craft a demonic workstation. Now that I should be able to. Yes. Can I make another void portal? I can with Batwing. That is why Batwings were important. So let's go again. One of these days I'll get lucky. Please kill him. Please kill that. Perfect. Oop. Nearly got hit by that. 1 in 4 drop, and what should be the last one that I need? This is insane. Can't believe how well this is going. My magic only playthrough was like way harder so far. But I guess starting off as a mage is also very difficult, as there's not many items you can use. Ouch, that did 33 damage for one hit. Okay, alright. Go away. Yes, and I kill him. Finish him off. God, stop running up. I need you. Did I get it? That looks like the summoning one. It is. Alright, let's get rid of the range one. Pop on the summoning one and chant that with extra damage as well. There we go. Let's get rid of that so I actually look kind of cool now. I wish the summoning foci gave you an extra summon too. That'd be real nice. What can I get rid of? Let's organize my pack first so I can see what to get rid of. Nothing yet. All right. What can I make now? So void stuff is summons. So I can actually go get the void stuff now. So let's take this with me and get the void stuff. And then hopefully if we come across a pirate island, that'll be nice. But I think we're in a good spot. We've now got 12 armor, 3 summons. My summons are enchanted with 15% damage. And I now get an extra 20% summon damage. Like, this is going so smooth. Especially being brutal mode. It is brutal mode, right? Yes, okay, it is brutal mode. For a second there, I was like, this is going too easy. Okay, I didn't think it would be this easy as a summoner, but I guess without that extra enchantment I got on the... Without the savage enchantment, it might have been a bit tougher because, as you saw before, I was doing one damage against polar bears. And I didn't think they had that crazy strong defense. I had to do this at night, didn't I? I also kill the sheep. So when I need all the wool. And then once I get the inducing amulet, that's another summon. So that should put me in a pretty good spot to tackle all the bosses and everything. I also got to keep my eyes peeled for an island that I might want. Please, please kill it. I know there's a ton of zombies as well, but kill him. He can teleport and then, like, mess up my life. Yeah. Well, so many zombies. Zombies? Yeah, zombies. But I was going to correct myself and say skeletons, but I would have got that wrong. All right, kill him. Thank you. Now kill the rest. I didn't get any void shards. That's super unfortunate. Well, I just got to wait till daytime. This is ridiculous. There's so many. Why is there so many? I never remember there being this many zombies ever for anything. And my snowmen are having a difficult time. There we go. Look, there's like another three more zombies. Four. All right, this will be good money though, because I get the maps. And maybe I use some of the maps for a pirate one. Like, can I just tell them to, like, go over there and kill them? Okay. Yes. That's two. I think I only need four. All right, kill him for me. Where are they off to? Where are they at, though? All right, please get him. Yes, now get him. Oh, what is my luck? There should be another wizard floating around. Yes, there is. And I might have to gamble it and, like, go inside the building. Go inside the building? The dungeon. All right, please get him. Nothing. All right. That's okay. Pop this down. What do I need? 4, 10... 13 in total I need. Okay. So I actually did need a lot more than just the two. I don't like an open spawn like that. That puts me in a very dangerous situation. Oh, that's nice though. Yeah, I'll take them. No zombies anyway, yeah? Not zombies, mages. Okay, that's actually a very clean dungeon. Maybe I tackle that after I get the armor. Because that armor puts me in a good spot. Wait, yes. Void Apprentice. That is what I'm looking for. Come. Ay! It's a cheap shot. Oh boy. Oh boy. That's the most damage I've taken. Alright. Psych! Alright, there we go. Two more void shards, that gets me the helmet. But I don't want to swap the armor until I've got a full set. Because then I lose out on one summon. Wait, enchanted crawling zombie. No, no, no! Oh, I went to use the thing. Damn it. I was trying to get to the stairs. No. Alright, when did I die? All right. Thankfully, I didn't die too far away. Let's just summon these guys back. Little scorpion. Right, sorry. Probably shouldn't have done that. Can you imagine if you, like, you kill enough little critters and they get, like, big boss critters? Like, killing a scorpion would summon the scorpion king. Like, little mini bosses like that would be so cool. And I keep saying that they need something for the water. The water is such a big part of the game. Sailing to and from islands, things like that. But there's nothing in the water. There's the occasional duck, and maybe a turtle, and then stone. Let's get some wool. Thank you. I don't know how much wool I had on me before, but I certainly need some. And let's grab the apple tree. Or apple trees. Holy heck, why is there so many apple trees? Because when I get settlers, they want a variety of food. Now, even if it's just basic food, it's still a variety. So let's get some blueberry bushes too. So they'll be harvesting blueberries, blackberries, and apples. That gives them three different types of food already. All right, there's all my stuff back. Is anything on the floor still? There is. What can I get rid of? Eat the blueberries. Melee focus, I don't need. And if you're wondering why I'm not combining them into the balance focus, is because the balanced one gives 15% to everything, whereas just the regular one gives 20%. Get rid of that. I don't need three of them. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Thank you. I'll take that. Nearly died in the process, but I'll take it. Let's keep exploring. How many did I get? 12? How many did I need again? 13, I think it was. So helmet, chest piece, and then I've got two and I need three, but I also need more wool. Okay. I didn't think wool was going to be the problem. I thought I got enough of that already. So what can I get rid of now? Let's eat up. I can probably get rid of the arrows. And maybe just some stone? Oh, I get rid of cave spider gland. Why not? Sort out my pack. Let's go back down. Get that last one. There's also a chest in here that I saw that I want. Yes. Please just drop one and then I'm done. Yes. Pop him. Yes. Perfect. Can I open that from here? I can. Nimble cloak. I'll take that. That. Cool. All right. Oh, I run so much faster. And now we make... Oh, I need more wool. Sorry, sheep. Two wool. That's four. If they each drop two wool, then I'm set. Yes, two. Two, that's eight. Great. I've now got void armor. So that is, this has been a fantastic start to this journey. We've now got, pop that there. We've now got 32 defense previously from that one. So what's that? Oh no. Oh no, I'm an idiot. Oh no, I made the wrong one. I was playing my mage only one before and then I got that one, but I need this one. I looked over it and I was like, why does it not say I get any summon? So that is a teeny bit unfortunate, but a little setback. We can come back from this. Get me out of here. I didn't realize there was a zombie creeping up on me. Sheep. Perfect. We are back off to two wool. So what did I need? Was it 12? It's 12 wool. Uh-oh. There's probably not even 12 wool on this island. So... Oh, there might be. If I made some shears, I could shear them and then kill them and get double the amount. I could have sworn there was a sheep. What's this? Seven? Okay. Okay, we can do this. Four more. Three more. There's three sheep. That's perfect. But I feel like I've just massacred all the sheep on this island. There's going to be nothing here for me. Apprentice enchanting scroll is useless. And that's useless to me as well. Void mask. There we go. 28 armor, and I've still got three summons, except now the difference is... What is the difference? Let's equip this all in the vanity slot. Just to compare. Oh, it doesn't say. Alright. Four armor, one summon, and this gets me seven armor, one summon, and 20% summon speed. That's huge. 13 armor, 5% damage. just 5 armor, so crazy improvement. And for the boots, 20% summon speed, 10% movement speed, 15% movement speed. So the 20% summon speed and from the helmet or the boots doesn't really make a difference then. They're all still buffed up exactly the same summon wise, but I just get more armor and a set bonus. Okay, so I'm going to leave the first episode here. Next episode, I'm going to tackle the pirate island, hopefully get another passive summoning weapon, and then we can tackle a couple bosses, I reckon, as well. So stick with me for the second episode. I'll be doing one video per week, unless something comes up and I want to put out 2 videos that week. But for now, 1 video, 1 week. So stick with me for this run. This is going to be crazy. Until then, I'll see you then. Bye.